The big breaking news we can bring you right now, the terrorist who was captured alive yesterday in Udhampur. He's been interrogated through the night, but different accounts coming in. Barkha Dutt now joins us on the phone line for more. Barkha, what are you hearing from your sources? What has the terrorist managed to tell investigators?
Well, Gargi, the focus of the investigators who have been interrogating Mohammed Naved through the night in that interrogation is still on. The focus of that interrogation was first try and pin him down on the infiltration route that the captured terrorist and his accomplice Noman used while entering Jammu and Kashmir. You will know that since yesterday, several contradictory versions have been coming out, not in the least contributed to by the absolutely vague and incoherent statements provided by Naved himself in that very strange taped interaction with local policemen and officers, where he spoke of first leaving Pakistan 12 days ago, then spoke of coming to Udhampur 2 days ago. Well, according to my sources, the contradictions have finally been resolved after sustained interrogation. This is what security forces and military intelligence and police officers believe happened. They are actually now saying that Naved infiltrated into Jammu and Kashmir not 12 days ago, not 2 days ago, but a month and a half ago when the period of Ramzan was still on. This is an important detail that we now know that Naved came in the period of Ramzan, that was a month and a half ago. Where did he go? Well, he has actually all this while been in the Kashmir Valley. Initially, the impression was that perhaps Naved and his accomplice, his co-terrorist, could have been part of the same module that attacked Gurdaspur, the police in Gurdaspur. There were suggestions that he may have come in from the international border in the Jammu region. My sources are saying none of this is true. They are saying that there is absolutely no linkage to Gurdaspur, to the Gurdaspur module, that is a separate module, and that Naved and his co-terrorist came in on an infiltration route into the Kashmir Valley. There still remain some inconsistencies as to which route along the line of control was taken. Was it Kupwara? Was it near Gulmarg? But this much is confirmed that all this while Naved has been in the Kashmir Valley, this captured terrorist, along with his co-terrorist, who was, of course, killed in this encounter with the BSF. Now, how did he come then to Udhampur? Our sources are saying that the interrogation reveals that he actually used a truck. He has used a truck. He was brought in on a truck. It's not clear who owned the truck, what they said to the truck owner, which truck this might be, but they were brought onto a truck. So this remains an unanswered question. Which truck was this? Who owned this truck? What happened to the truck? We don't know. But our sources are saying that the captured terrorist accomplice took a truck from Kashmir to Udhampur with specific orders to target the part of the highway that is south of the Banihal tunnel. So it was a very specific location. They were told to target military convoys that often travel on this stretch. And to me, this remains a kind of mysterious, unanswered zone. Who supplied this truck? Did they just take a lift on the highway? Did they use violence and their weapons to threaten a truck driver into giving them this lift? Did they know the truck driver? We don't know. But we are being told repeatedly that a truck was used to make the journey from Kashmir to Udhampur. And finally, Gargi, we are being told that the one thing that Naved, the captured terrorist, has been consistent on is the details of where he comes from in Pakistan, that he originates from Faisalabad, that he has two brothers, that one brother is a teacher in a college and the other is in the hosiery business, and that he is also, by his own account, been trained by the Lashkar-e-Taiba. So this is the details, these are exclusive details that we are accessing about what Naved has told interrogators so far. That interrogation on through the night, it's still on. Some of these details perhaps could change because the terrorist keeps changing them himself. And therefore, it has been difficult for interrogators to actually cull out what they believe is consistent. And the most important new point we are bringing to you is this, that he has been in the Kashmir Valley for over a month and a half. He has been in the Kashmir Valley. He did not enter through the international border. He did not. And, the questions will arise. Where was he hiding? Was he hiding near the line of control? Did he come into one of the major cities? you know, how long did it take him? Which point did he take the truck from? These are questions that we still have to dig deeper into. Who helped him? Was it outside help? Was it local help? These are questions that persist. But these are the new details that are emerging at this point. The captured terrorist enters Jammu and Kashmir through the Kashmir Valley, which means it's not the international border. It is, in fact, the line of control, which, by the way, is much more difficult to man. Despite the fencing of the LOC, the terrain is such that it is a much more difficult area. And you know, security forces have often said that it is impossible to actually man every little bit of the LC. So we know he's coming through the line of control. We know he's been hiding along with his accomplice in the valley. We now know that he is claiming to have taken a truck to come to Udhampur. We know that his orders were to target a particular stretch of the highway, which is south of the Banihal, and we now know that there is, there was talk initially that there might have been more than two terrorists. We've been told that there are no more than two terrorists. And we also know now that there's no linkage at all with Gurdaspur, as was being reported yesterday. Gargi.
All right, so Barkha, then you're confirming, or you've learned from your sources, that there were no other terrorists, because that was something that was being speculated, that perhaps there were more people with Naved.
Well, you see, Gargi, initially in the confusion when the encounter first started and the BSF soldiers were attacked, there was a sort of initial account that there may have been more than one terrorist who escaped. But at the moment that is absolutely being denied, that is being denied. We are being told that these were the only two terrorists, that one has been killed and one has been taken alive. We also know that Naved was caught on a hilltop. We know that an AK-47 and some grenades were recovered from him. And we also know that this was a planned attack. This did not just happen. They didn't just happen to be on the highway and start opening fire at random. They were, in fact, sent in from the Kashmir Valley. They were sent in from the Kashmir Valley, specifically to the south of the Banihal tunnel on the highway. So, Gargi, this is a new picture emerging. Right. The new picture emerging is that these terrorists entered 1.5 months ago. Questions will arise, where were they all this while? How did they remain undetected in the valley for this long? The answer to that might be that security forces will say that it is impossible to detect every single infiltrator, every single militant, every single terrorist who comes in. But we know now that this captured terrorist has been in the Kashmir Valley, in Jammu and Kashmir, for the last month and a half. And the one inconsistency remains on which infiltration route he used. The other question that I would be curious to get more answers to is, in fact, what happened to that truck? If he took a truck from Kashmir to Udhampur, what was his point of starting in Kashmir? Which area was it? And whose truck was this? And where did the truck driver go? These remain inconsistent or rather unanswered questions that, in fact, will be brought upon the security forces and the local police to answer. But these are the exclusive details we are bringing you at this moment, piecing together what Naved, the captured terrorist, has told interrogators thus far.